May I request HOD, Head of the Department of Computer Science, Mr. Vamsi, to felicitate our Mr. Pradeep Kote, TCS Recruitment Head. Sir, please. ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೆಟರ್ನಿಟಿ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೀನ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಕೀಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಬ್ರೀಫ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಶೋರ್ ಎಸ್ಟೀಮ್ಡ್ ಕಲೀಗ್ಸ್ present on the stage here, some of them from product organizations and some from fellow services organizations, have already stressed on various opportunities that are there in the industry, and I am sure there will be more speakers later who will also touch upon some of the specific or the domain specific ingredients that you may want to take back to your management, your institute managements and the faculties to ensure that we build a much stronger future. So I'll just quote one small line and then maybe we will try and discuss further around that one line. And I'll also try and give some example to justify that line as well. So something that I read somewhere, it says, and this is nothing to do with IT or education or anything, it's a common statement that I'm going to read out. And this is a line that I read somewhere on LinkedIn. It says, when the rules of the game change, the weak will perish, the mediocre will just comply, they will try to adjust some way, nudge plus or minus and try to comply to it. The good ones will adapt very quickly and somehow manage to run, go with the flow. And the smart ones, I think that's where we'll have to concentrate going forward. The smart ones will constantly reinvent themselves and stay relevant. Now, if you look at how things have changed over the last 4 or 5 years, I'm sure it is similar for most of my colleagues from the services side. We used to have a set of accredited colleges. I'm sure many of you will be aware of it. Some of you have been part of those institutes. Now we have changed that game. I'm not speaking only for TCS, but if you look at large organizations, I think with the volume, with the scale that we are looking at, the game has already changed in the last 3 years or 4 years. The buzzword is no more about degree or qualification, the buzzword is more about skill today. I think NASSCOM also was stressing on that point, that it is more to do with skill. That is what the government is trying to work out with the new education policy, and kudos to VTU, Director CPC is here. VTU has already taken the stance in terms of pushing this NEP into rest of the institutes. There is, I'm sure, all round, like what the Mridangam example was given. I think from every corner, there is a lot of change that is already taking place. The reason why I'm stressing on that line again on the smart ones is, I think our smartness is going to be measured only based on the pace at which we are making this change now. Now the change is already imminent, it is already there in the market. Some of us are at a forefront, some of the organizations are still catching up, or they are working out models that work well for them, keeping their business interests. No matter what, I think we are going to be in a space where It is going to be skill-based evaluations going forward. It is more to do with the volume or the national level evaluations. It is not going to be college specific anymore. The competition is no more between any college. I don't want to take an example of any college because of obvious reasons, but it's not going to be college A fighting with itself. It is going to be students across the country trying to gain that mind space with XYZ organization. Now, with this scenario, the other challenge, which is a big challenge, I think, from the placement officer's point of view, which I don't want to consider it as any minor challenge, I think this is going to be a big challenge now, is to ensure that we still stay relevant, because today, I think 2021, has been absolutely fantastic for engineering students. But we all know what things can, you know, how quickly the things can change. You know, we have seen that in the past. The smart ones are the ones who will learn from these things and try and understand how to stay relevant. And what we do during this time is the one that is going to set the tone for the tough times ahead as well. So, the challenge for the placement officers, the career counselors that are there, out there in the educational institutions, is to stay relevant, make sure the students stay relevant for those tough times ahead. And for that, I think the planning that we do today is going to be a key. So, reaching out, staying connected with the industry, because I think today industry is reaching out to you. All those good ones are getting placed, irrespective of what the situation is. But are we geared up for that one day, you know, when the things are going to be difficult, or when the things are not going to be as good as what it is today? Maybe that's what we will need to focus on. You know, that's the only point that I would like to stress here. So from a placement officer's point of view, maybe use all those various examples that I have already quoted, with the NEP coming in, with the relaxation the university has also brought in terms of inter-stream collaboration that you can do within your respective institutes, where you can ensure that the students of mechanical engineering also have a visibility to what is happening on the computer science side, or electronics and communication students are aware of what is happening on the mechanical. You know, this cross-branch interaction is something that is going to put you in a good control, maybe with 2-3 years down the line. So you may want to consider these options. Rest of the things, I'm sure we are engaged already in exceptional way. We have already kept all the placement officers individually, through the groups, through VTU, informed about various initiatives, various profiles that the organization comes with, the post-offer engagement, the Explore platform, the digital capability assessments that every offered student has. You know, everyone from TCS who gets an offer has an opportunity to go through the digital capability assessment even before they join, and then they can upgrade their offer. Those who are not able to do so before they join will get multiple opportunities. I think something similar to what Vipro was talking about, during the next, you know, 2.5 to 3 years, multiple opportunities. So these are common. I'm sure industry is also aware of the requirements of the student community, and we are also evolving, and these are various opportunities that each one of us are bringing to the table. So I hope, as a community, as a close-knit group of placement officers, all of us, you know, all of us, when I say we included, from the HR fraternity, whatever support we can extend, we will continue to do so. Together, let us try and make this a better place. Let us ensure we provide the best possible future, best possible career to our students, and ensure that they stay committed, you know, to the organization that they are having an offer from. Else, things will get a lot more difficult. I think those are the only analytics that HRs today are doing, you know, how committed are the students from each of those institutes who are joining us. You know, these are the data analytics that we all do, and I'm sure that is going to have a bigger say in terms of, you know, what we do going forward. So we hope all of you will continue to focus on this, and I'm sure we will continue to engage through various informal sessions or interactions as well. And I wish all of you and all the students the very best in their careers. Thank you so much.
I remember the days almost 10-15 years back. If Infosys is coming, TCS says, no, we will not come. If TCS says, so from that era, today all the legendaries are here. A big applause from the fraternity of the training and placement community.